Hey y'all, good morning. How are you? So it's the next day. I actually couldn't even do the guacamole yesterday because I didn't have avocados. I did have avocados, but they weren't bad. So we're gonna go get some gas, grab some avocados, and then I'll show y'all how I make my guacamole. So good. And then I told y'all we didn't have any chips anyway. So I mean, what good is guacamole with no chips anyway? I did get the chips. I ran to Target yesterday. And I got the cutest little gingerbread cookie cutters. They're so cute from Target. I'll show y'all when I get home. But yeah, so gas, avocados, guacamole. So I'll check in with you guys when I get to the store. Grocery shopping. I actually decided to get more than just avocados, and we're here at Wendy's. Y'all, their breakfast is so good. Can I have a number four? I'll have coffee.
All right, did you want cream or sugar?
No, thank you. Can I also have an order of French toast sticks?
Four, six.
Four.
Will that be it?
That's it.
10:19, come on around.
Thank you.
Oh, man.
Thank you.
Have a great day.
You too. What's up, y'all? So we are back home. I just got home from going grocery shopping. I decided to do a cheat day today. We're gonna have Wendy's breakfast. Y'all, have you guys had Wendy's breakfast? These breakfast potatoes are like my favorite. I got the honey butter chicken biscuit. I don't see any honey butter, but I think it's already absorbed. So I've never had this before. It's good. I like it. I would buy it again. I got some coffee. I poured it in a glass because I didn't want to burn myself. I love me some black coffee. I got some French toast sticks too because I'm a fat girl. And I love me some French toast sticks, but I'm not gonna eat it right now. I'm gonna wait. That'll be like a snack later. It's not hot anyway, so I'll have to heat it up. Fun fact about me, I don't have a microwave. I don't know. I'm kind of like skeptical about them. I don't know how they like actually affect my food, so I don't use them. So good. Y'all should try some black coffee. It's so good. I've been drinking black coffee for a long time. Usually when I have coffee in the morning, I'm fasting, so I'm only drinking it by itself. But eating and having black coffee on the side. I don't know what it is about it, but it is so good. Anyway, I'm gonna finish my food and then I'll show you guys what I got from the grocery store. Hey y'all. Okay, so I'm gonna show y'all what I got. So I got some asparagus. I love asparagus. And I shop at Lidl a lot. I do a lot of my shopping at Target and Lidl. Love them. These tortillas are so good. The Banderita carb counter tortillas. And I get these to make like little burrito taco, soft taco joints. A little candle lighter. Green onion. Cilantro. I got the avocados, y'all. And I didn't get lime because I already have lime. I got some crushed tomatoes. I want to try to make like a marinara sauce, you know, for like pasta. I got some vanilla unsweetened almond milk. And when you, not when, but if you're someone who buys nut milks, like vegan plant-based milks, I highly suggest you take a look at what's like what the ingredient list is, because sometimes they put ingredients in there that probably just should not be in there. So like oat milk, for example, I've never tried oat milk. I said that funny. I've never tried oat milk before. This is the Planet Oat milk. Unsweetened original. And the ingredients on this looks pretty good. But if you take a look at the ingredients, especially when it comes to oat milk, a lot of the times you'll find out that they add sugar into that milk. They also add sunflower oil into the milk. And I think that they use the oil to create that thickness. I've never tried oat milk, and I've never tried, obviously, this brand, but I'm sure it's creamy enough. I don't want oil in my milk. I don't know. That just sounds kind of crazy to me. I got some strawberries. And they smell good. And you guys, I love pasta. I don't have a lot of it because I'm just bringing the carbs down, but I love this bronze cut spaghetti. Well, not just the spaghetti, they have bronze cut linguine, but I just got spaghetti this time. And so like the imported Italian pasta, see this one says imported from Italy, and they usually come in, the packaging is always a lot nicer on these than, I don't know, like the typical cardboard boxes you would get. I get this from Lidl. They get a lot of their things imported. I'm pretty sure this is one of, this is Lidl branded, but it's an imported Italian pasta that they package in here. But this bronze cut pasta is so good. If you shop at Target, I would definitely suggest like their signature pastas. They're really good. They have a bucatini pasta that's so good. I love that one. They also have a radiator. Not even sure if I'm saying that right, but that is really, really good too. They almost look like little baby lasagnas. So I don't know. I love pasta. I try not to eat as much of it because I'm trying to, you know, decrease my fat loss. But we got some steak and some smoked sausage in here. Beef smoked sausage. I want to make some feijoada. So I'm gonna bring this bag over here. I want to make some feijoada. I'm not sure if you guys have tried that, but it's like a Brazilian dish that has like steak and beans and sausage. And it is so good. I haven't made it in a while, so I want to make that. I have some cucumber. And Lidl, I try to buy grass-fed as much as I can. Like, yeah, so we have some grass-fed ground beef here. Like, when I buy meat, I really try my best to buy quality meat. And Lidl is really, really good for that. They have grass-fed ground beef. Target has grass-fed ground beef as well. And so if you can choose, I definitely would. When you're eating animal protein, it's important to consider the source, because toxins are just naturally held in the fat stores. And so if you're eating, you know, poor quality meat, you know, you could be taking in, you know, toxins and stuff more than you might realize and stuff. So do your research, just, you know, choose wisely. I always say when you buy things, you're pretty much like voting with your money. So make sure that you're making conscious choices, you know what I'm saying? So I got a lot of wings because Lidl's the only place I can find organic free range wings. And when everyone was like, oh, you know, there's a wing shortage, I never felt that, because Lidl always got some wings, and organic wings at that. And I bought this too. I like baby back ribs. I've never made them myself. These are already cooked. Yeah, these are already cooked. I think they brought these out for the holidays. So they're baby back ribs with barbecue sauce, slow cooked. So I got some of that because my daughter and I love some wings. I mean, we do love wings, but we love baby back ribs. Another cucumber. More sausage. Rosé. I haven't had rosé in a while because I actually haven't been to Lidl in a while. I've just been grabbing things at Target and Walmart, really, the last few weeks. I got some crema de coco and leche de coco. So coconut milk and coconut cream. Oh, cream of coconut. The black beans for the feijoada. And we're going to be making some cookies soon. So I got some of this Betty Crocker cookie icing, the white one. Does this have dyes in it? No, it doesn't. Okay. I try not to really like get things with, you know, food coloring and stuff like that. I don't know. It just doesn't sit right with me. Taco seasoning, reduced sodium taco seasoning. And yeah, that's all I got from the grocery store. I'm going to put all of this away and then we're going to go ahead and make the guacamole. All right, y'all, let's go ahead and make the guacamole. I'll leave the ingredients below. The first thing I'm going to do is rehydrate this cilantro. This is the Gourmet Garden chopped cilantro, lightly dried. Once you open it, it's supposed to stay fresh for 4 weeks. This entire thing is supposed to be the equivalent of an entire bunch of cilantro like this. I prefer fresh cilantro. Fresh ingredients are always better, but when I had originally purchased the ingredients for this, they didn't have fresh cilantro at Target. The reviews on this was not good. I ended up getting it just because it was all that they had. It says that this is, it says 1 tablespoon equals 2 tablespoons of fresh cilantro. So I'm going to, what does it say? Sorry. 1 tablespoon. Okay. So if you have fresh cilantro, you can chop up the cilantro so that it gives you 2 tablespoons like this. So we're just going to put 1 tablespoon of this dried one, and we're gonna add liquid to the bowl to like rehydrate it. And the way we're gonna do that, well, the way I'm gonna do it is using the lime juice that the recipe calls for. So I'm just going to use my juicer and you just place it in there like that. This is a pretty heavy duty one. It's the, I think, the Pioneer Woman brand from Walmart. And we're just gonna squeeze and get as much of that juice out all over this dried cilantro and just allow that to rehydrate as we prepare the other ingredients. And this juicer is pretty good, but if you want to get every drop, I just like squeeze my fingers into the lime like this, and you can often get even more juice out of the lime. You'll know which avocado to use because it'll have some give to it. It'll almost like clay or Play-Doh. These three are the hardest, so I'm just gonna put these aside. These ones seem like they're just barely ready, but we're gonna go with it. You just wanna cut all the way around your avocado twist. It's gonna look like that. Hopefully I'm in frame. You're gonna take this knife carefully. You're gonna start with it like this, and you're gonna quickly apply pressure so that you pierce the inside of that seed and you can twist it out, okay? Just like that. And we can just put this aside. Okay, I'm gonna show you guys again. So you just come around the avocado like this with the knife. And just connect that line around. So you give it a little twist like this. And this one is, I got really uneven here, but try to get as center as you can. Okay, and we're gonna do the same thing again. And I kind of put it on the side, so let's try again. Okay, just like that. And if you're a little baby, you know, you're a little kid, whatever, you know, make sure you do this with your mom or your dad. Okay, and again. We're gonna do the avocado first because avocado, just like bananas and apples, they start to oxidize, which means that they're gonna start, this nice bright green color is gonna start to turn brown if we don't coat it with some lime juice or lemon juice. So we're gonna cut this in half again. So we have just in half this way. Oh, in half this way. So we have these two slices, and you're just going to peel the skin off. And make sure you have ripe avocados, because if you don't have ripe avocados, the skin won't come off, or it'll at least give you quite a bit of trouble. So we're just going to peel the skin from the avocado. Let me just go over what you'll need. You'll need some cilantro, garlic, avocados, of course, tomatoes. Oh my gosh, there goes all of my seeds. Of course, you're gonna need some tortilla chips to eat the guacamole with, or you can have it in a taco or burrito bowl or something like that. Salt, and if you like spicy, cayenne pepper. I have salt, I need to go grab it. Okay, so all of our avocados are peeled. You can use your fork to give the cilantro a little stir here. I really hope that this cilantro is just as flavorful as fresh. But from there, you're just going to chop your avocado into chunks. Nothing perfect, because we're gonna give it a little bit of a mash with this fork anyway. those with the juice and cilantro mixture. And I was actually gonna use this fork to start mashing it, but it's actually gonna take forever with that fork. So I have one of these mashers that my mom gave me, and I'm just gonna take this and just start giving it a little bit of a mash, start getting it to be that texture we want. Put that to the side. So this is what we have, and then we're moving on. So you're gonna wanna put at least one tomato in here. I like Roma tomatoes, that's what I would typically use, which is about 4 ounces. Or is it 2 ounces? I'm not sure, but I know that I'm using grape tomatoes, and I'm going to put about 12 of these in there. With these smaller tomatoes, it's very easy to kind of smash them and burst them if you don't know how to cut them or you don't have a sharp knife. So what you want to do is start with the tip of the knife. You want to kind of poke the skin of the tomato to get through that skin, and then you can go ahead and slice. And that's how I go about doing it.
I'm outside in an AMG, right outside, TT, two-turn baby girl, you know me, still with the go.
This is my 8th tomato that I'm putting in here, and I think I'm actually going to stop right here. So I'm going to give this a mix. Take a look at how it looks. You know, you can just eyeball it and ask yourself, like, is that enough tomato? Do I want to add more? That's where we are right now. I think it looks pretty good. I'm gonna stop with the tomato for now. I can always add more. We're gonna add some garlic. I'm gonna give it a little bit of mix. This is minced garlic in water. I'm just gonna eyeball this. I can use this fork and just take a little bit like that. Maybe too little. Maybe a teaspoon about. Okay, I do like a little bit of cayenne. Oof, I hope that wasn't too much. We're gonna do some salt. This is sea salt right here. Okay, we can give this a nice little mix. We added our garlic. Sea salt, a bit of cayenne pepper. I don't have any jalapenos. But cayenne will totally do the trick. So we're just peeling off the skin of this onion. You cut the top and bottom, and then from there you can cut this way, like very shallow into the skin, so you can easily peel off that skin off of the onion. Okay. I think I'm just going to do, so if I cut this half in two threes, I think I'm just gonna do a third of this onion. And you want this to be pretty thin. Go over the onions a few times. Be careful, watch your fingers. I'm just going to go over this a couple of times. Make sure that I can get the onion as small as possible. Just be careful. And then from there you can scoop up the onion on the knife and just push it right off into the bowl. Okay, so we got everything in here. Alright, I just wanted to clean off the table so we can go ahead and get into this. So this is the exact same recipe I always use, and it is so good. Actually, I want to taste it by itself. It's pretty good, honestly. It's not bad with that dried cilantro. It's definitely not as strong and fresh of a cilantro flavor, but the cilantro flavor does come through and it's pretty good. But if you use fresh cilantro, that's what I'm always gonna be hitting. Super good. I just had breakfast, so I really am just gonna save this for later. But if you just want a healthy snack that you can eat throughout the week, take with you to work, pack for your kids after school or at lunch or whatever, definitely recommend. My daughter loves guacamole. She's gonna be happy. When she gets off, she's at work. When I pick her up, I'm gonna tell her we got some guacamole, baby. She's gonna be real happy because she loves guacamole. But yeah, I hope you guys try the recipe. Gotta watch the time because it's flying right by. I'm outside.